BART event where survival of the machinery is second to personal pride. If you can't run with the big dog, stay on the porch. The big dog in qualifying was Bobby Labonte, but his time at the front lasted less than a lap. In the first 30-lap scramble, Jeff Gordon sent the signal, stay with me or run for second. In the second 30-lap segment, the annual fan-voted inverted start signaled it was time for carnage. Two laps in, Jimmy Spencer tried to press for the front and pressed too hard. Schrader was incensed after the incident, storming to the NASCAR trailer. Spencer carried on. The silver number three of Earnhardt was also involved. He escaped this time, but would not be so lucky later. The second big melee in segment two took out Mark Martin, Dale Jarrett, and select Open winner Todd Bodine. Spencer, meanwhile, survived another near miss. Through it all, Jeff Gordon was stealing the show and the cash, winning the second $50,000 segment bonus as he completed a last-to-first charge, sweeping the first two segments. But the Select Grand Finale is always NASCAR's best fireworks show, proving that old age and treachery will always win out over youth and enthusiasm. Darrell Waltrip and Dale Earnhardt seized the early advantage. Earnhardt made it three wide down the backstretch as the two veterans swept to the front. That meant Gordon had the best seat when the wheels came off in front of him. The Silver 3 breaks loose in turn four and carries Waltrip into the wall hard. Both walked away from the wreck while Gordon walked away from the field. Sterling Marlin gave chase to no avail. In the final laps, Gordon had time to fill out his deposit slip for $300,000, coasting to his first Winston Select win.
Hey, I love Bruton Smith, man. I love to take his money, and I think he...
Pro Stock Round 1 is yet to be run, but of course, everybody is talking about the tragedy that hit the Wayne County Speed Shop in Fairfield, Illinois. We showed some video yesterday on NHRA Today, and whoever broke in there knew exactly what they were doing, where to place their sledgehammers, where to ruin the blocks, the heads, the manifolds. Just an unthinkable act, and it appears that they won't be back for about two races.
All right, Steve, we look forward to hearing more about that. Terrible indeed that Scott Jeffrey and Darrell Alderman can't make the show today. Thanks for your report. Steve will be back with live coverage of the final round of the Mopar Parts Nationals right here on TNN, 5 o'clock Eastern today. And a full recap on race day tonight, 7:30 Eastern time. We sometimes forget just how dangerous a sport auto racing is, and there are a few...
Out of control, and he was killed. There is currently no explanation for the cause of this accident. Racing is a high-risk sport, and no one knows that better than the men who do it. But nothing could prepare myself, my crew, or the Arnett family for what we'd be unfortunate enough to witness that day at El Mirage. This story is being aired at the family's request. We offer them our deep condolences and thank them for allowing us to air this footage in its entirety. For TNN Race Day, this is Laura Bird.
All right, thanks, Laura.